guys, MUR-LOCK 68. Hope everybody's doing well today. It's time to tackle a beast. There are a lot of beasts present in the room. This one here is 2 ounces short of 3 pounds. 3 pounds. So 2 pounds. 14 ounces, just about. 70 millimeters. 14 1/4 millimeter shackle. I think we're gonna have fun. This thing has got a spring-loaded shutter to make your life a living hell. Dual ball bearing. I can't even show you guys the keyway right now. It's just buried behind this shutter. So we're gonna try and tackle this and see what happens. Maybe figure out how to tension it as well. I think I showed this in the package opening last video. So yeah, you've got a spring-loaded shutter here. Reminds me of the same spring-loaded shutter that comes in the 270 Lockwood. So let's see, we've got a 6-pinner here, trying to see if I can, is that ever nasty. Love to show that keyway. Yeah, they've done a good job here. So let's see where we're at. If I can find these pins. Okay, I didn't get any tension there, so that's a good way to start. More and more I do these keyways, it's just a matter of figuring out your pick placement. This is a 6-pinner. That's pin 4. I had nothing on 1 and 2. Yeah, this is a pretty nasty, nasty warding. Okay, I just dropped the 2 pins that I had set. Should be an interesting gut as well. But I definitely will not get ahead of myself. 1, 2. Now I've either overset something here. I will hold this in hand for a little bit anyway. Okay, I'm gonna check pin 2. Okay, binder there on one, and I got a click out of it. I haven't quite figured out the tension yet. It might be a little too heavy. Okay, I just got a false set. Okay. Okay, so now I've got to make sure I maintain my tension, maintain my composure. I think it's pinned way at the back. I just went into a deeper fault set there. That was pin number 5. At this point, I want to be careful that I'm not catching warding and getting a false sense of, a counter rotation that doesn't exist that could cost me. So I'm just going to take my time here, go through these pins and see who it is. Definitely got my fault set, and I think it's pin number 2. I'm trying to lift it as much as I can here. Stuck between the warding here. Trying to get a view. Let's see. Well, the only one I feel solid is pin number 2, and I can't get it to move. I'll have to, keep switching back and forth because I'm going to drop this tension. That's pin number 2. Solid. Okay, I'm going to go in with a different hook. I might not be getting it up high enough. That was not, that was warding. I think I might be in need of some manual counter rotation. Yeah, when you don't have a spring-loaded core, pros and cons. I'm trying to feel for that counter rotation, but I'm not having much luck here. still a firm believer it's pin number two. Still cannot. It's not set. It's not springy. Yep, pin number two, solid. Really? I don't mind breaking the pick to get the open. Got very little tension on here. I can't get anything out of any other pin. Okay. Gotta try something. don't know for the life of me what's holding me from getting this pin up. Just trying a different angle. I think my tension's a little too heavy on this angle. I'm in an awkward position. Think I could get this tensioner back where I had it? Not a chance. Not a chance. There we go. Let's go back to work. I think I lost my fault set. just dropped all my pins. Not getting anything out of it now. Good fault set. It's long gone. Starting to lose my my grip on this lock. That was a prime example of me thinking I was getting counter rotation, and I was hooked on the warding and lost my pins there. which is gonna happen if you start to get impatient, which is normal. At this point, as I always say, you got decisions to make, right? Either you're in or you're out. And I've made a commitment to myself to get into this damn thing, so. I've got to keep an eye on my tensioner. And pick placement again so I don't lose what I have. I've got, I believe, 3 pins already set. 4. That was number 3. Now I'm in a deep fault set. Okay. What's the problem? What am I missing here? What am I missing here? Definitely dealing with some sort of spool. I'm gonna go with a thinner pick for a second. I don't think. Okay, I'm feeling counter. I let go for a second because I'm going to try and determine whether it's the warding or I'm actually getting true counter. So I'm going to go back here. should have stayed on it. Back to the same problem with pin number two. Seems to be the one that's giving me grief. And I just broke my fucking pick. That's a custom pick too. So now it's personal. It's fucking personal now. Personal. All appointments have been canceled. Exactly what I said I shouldn't do. Jammed it in between that warding. And that, my friends, gives you a broken pick. Silliness now. Taking my pick. Now you're trying to take my composure. Thank you. probably not open here. I am open, come on. Something has happened here. There it is. There it is. Look at the rust. Look at that. No excuses. I got beat up there for a while. Cost me a custom pick. Gonna head straight into counseling, some therapy. Now we gotta stop talking shit. Because we've beaten them. Now we gotta see what it's gonna take to gut this thing. Let's have a look. Crap in there. Holy shit. You know what? This was a very, very used lock. You can tell it's been used. So now we run into that same problem where we've got a roll pin here to deal with. So I'm going to put that aside. I'm going to get my friends here. In case you didn't already know, it was pin number two. I want to see what these pins look like because you see I had trouble getting that open. It was definitely pin number two that held me back forever. So, let's see how this roll pin plays out here. Okay, that came out. Alright, so the least we can do is give me a little bit of help. So there's a rusted out roll pin. Shackle. And another screw. Kind of liking so what they've done here as opposed to the other one, they've threaded the back of the plate. Yep, there's my other screw. Holy crap. All right, I'm gonna need some so this is the plate, the spring-loaded plate. Wow. I think I'm going to have some fun here. Just bear with me, guys. There's a lot of gunk here. I'm going to try and just wipe this down. Yeah, I'm kind of liking this setup where the screws go right into the plate as opposed to alright, so what I need to do here, and of course I did not pay attention, so common problem with me as to where this went, but I'll figure it out. Yeah, I've seen that exact same plate or spring-loaded shutter on the holy shit. Alright, well, okay, that's the cam. We're going to leave that as it is. We're going to go after the core. We're going to gut this. And I will do my best, as always. This looks like the exact core that was in the other one, but this one here has got a lot of rust on it. It's got that same stupid clip on it. So. Sure who designed this freaking clip, but it's a piece of junk. Now we've got it spinning, and what I want to try to do now, no, I cannot do that. Alright, I'm going to lock this up. Go figure, eh? There's the clip. There's the key. Yeah, it's one of the nastiest I've seen. But again, just about pick placement and getting yourself through there is what I believe. So let's run this through the garden, see what we got. I don't expect a lot. I know we've got some spools in there. It's going to be a lot cleaner when it goes back together. We've got quite a bit of rust here. So we've got 6 pins. Everything had to be picked, as you can see there. So let's dump them out. I don't know if they're going to come out willingly. The answer is no. So take another 20-25 minutes to get this done. 1, 2, 3. Sorry about the focus. Six, all standard pins, nothing done to the core here. What do we got? So we've Got the front here. Let's pull that shim out. And yeah, we've got that mushroom. So with the smaller diameter on top, just so we're clear on that. Now this thing is just gonna be a fight right to the end. Copper spring, probably same setup. Good luck, that spring is jammed. That's number three. Definitely well used lock. There's number four, standard. Not a chance. There's the spring for number four. So we should have another mushroom or a torpedo in this chamber, and we do. And there's your spring. Let's go to the last chamber, which should be standard. See if I can get that last spring out. There it is. It's compacted a little bit. Okay, guys. The K200, a beast hidden behind a nasty keyway, three torpedoes, we've seen that before, seems to be a staple for these. And by the looks of it, pin number two, one of my biggest problems, by the looks of it now, was a zero cut that needed to go up into the ceiling, and I couldn't do it because of the way the warding was positioned. So there you go. Not a bad key, but have a look at that. That's a 0-1 cut, maybe. All the way up to the top, there's the key. K200, guys, SPP gut for you guys today. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Thanks for sticking by on this long journey. I didn't show the pins this time, did I? You're gonna see photos and all that stuff anyway. As always. So you've got three torpedoes there in 1, 3, and 5, all standard pins. I wonder if that compressed spring in 2 had added some flavoring to this pick. But that's it. Thanks, guys, appreciate your support. Hit the like button, subscribe, leave a comment, and patience, practice, perseverance. Stay well, see you in the next one.